Good morning, students. My name is Akash Tiwari, and I welcome you all in today's class. Today we are covering the chapter Microorganism, Friend and Foe, Class 8, chapter number 2. In first part, we have seen about the introduction about microorganism, about microscope, of course, and about the various types of microorganism, bacteria, fungi, algae, protozoa. Various types of microorganism are present around us. We have seen some of the common diseases which are being because of this microorganism. We see some of these friendly microorganism. What are their purpose? Why they are being used? So these were the key points which we were covered in the first part. In second part, we are going to see some of the topics from, of course, these are about the friendly microorganism, and we are going to cover about the friendly microorganism in today's topic. Okay, let's see. We are starting with making of curd and bread. Okay, so of course, in making of, if we are talking about the curd, you all might have heard about the lactobacillus bacteria. What do these lactobacillus bacteria do? What happens whenever you take milk in a container, and when you kept it for some time, or you add a few drop of curd in milk which you want to convert it into curd, what happens? This milk starts converting into curd slowly and slowly. It takes approximately 6 to 8 hours. Within 6 to 8 hours, it gets converts into curd. Okay, this was the all about conversion of milk into curd. Why did this happen? Because of this lactobacillus bacteria. They are very important. This bacteria multiplies continuously in milk and convert it into curd. Of course, what happens actually in microorganism, their life cycle are very small. They some microorganism live for few hours. So this type of microorganism, what do they do? Wherever we are using it in any of the substance, they start getting multiply themselves. Because of this multiplication, they increases their number very fastly, due to which they convert it into the useful products, which are being, for example, here this lactobacillus bacteria is converting milk into curd. Why they are converting? Because they are multiplying very fastly, because of which we are getting conversion of milk into curd very fastly. Within approximately 6 to 8 hours, they are we can get our curd. Okay, so this was all about the conversion of milk into curd. Now let's see preparation of bread. How a bread is being formed? Well, preparation of bread, cake, pastries, idli, suji, this type of things, what we are doing, we are using yeast. We are using here yeast. What does this yeast do? They reproduce rapidly and also increases carbon dioxide during respiration. This gas mixed with ingredients thus increases its volume. Very important point here. What this yeast do? When we add yeast to our food items like bread, cake, etc., for making the ingredients, we are adding yeast into it. When yeast is being added, what happens? Yeast starts reproducing themselves. When they start reproducing themselves, of course, they respire into it. They take a breathing. What they do breathing process in it. And because of this breathing process, they release carbon dioxide gas. As of course, we also do the same thing. Whatever we are doing, the same is being done by yeast also. So they take inside oxygen, they breathe outside carbon dioxide. Okay, this carbon dioxide mixed with your food items like bread, cake, idli, suji, this type of item, they get mixed with it. And because of this carbon dioxide or gas, your food items get increase in size. Like in cake, you have seen when you take the dough, It's in very small in size, but when you get the product, final product, final cake, then you see its volume increases. It becomes bigger in size. Okay, this is because of the yeast present in it. Now let's see commercial use of microorganism. What are being used in? How they are used in industry in the industrial application? So in industrial application, yeast is used in the production of alcohol, wine, etc. So main role of here of microorganism is being performed by yeast. Very important process. They are used in commercial purpose in production of alcohol and wine. These are they bring lot of money to government. So government plays important. Government has important role for this alcohol, wine, etc. Let's see further. Process of conversion of sugar into alcohol in the presence of yeast is called fermentation. This is a process. In this process, what happens here? Yeast. What is the role of yeast here? They attack on the sugar. They convert it into alcohol because of yeast. So this process where sugar is converted into alcohol in the presence of yeast is called fermentation. Remember this now, fermentation, very important. Here what is happening? Sugar is converted into alcohol in the presence of yeast. Okay, this process is called fermentation. Now let's come very important part, medicinal use. Of course, when we talk about the medicinal use, you might be surprising that how microorganisms are used in medicines. So let's see. You have, of course, when you went to doctor, when you get sick, doctor always gives you antibiotics. Some type of capsule or tablet is being there. Doctor gives you. These antibiotics are the medicines made up of bacteria and fungi. Very important. Antibiotics are the medicines made up of bacteria and fungi. These antibiotics, which we are taking when we get ill, is being made up of bacteria and fungi, which kills disease for the microorganism. Very important. Antibiotics are made up of bacteria and fungi, and they are attacking on whom? Those who are causing disease-causing microorganism. They are attacking on disease-causing microorganism. One microorganism is attacking on second microorganism. You are trying to understand what I am trying to say here. One type of microorganism is attacking on second type of microorganism here. So antibiotics are microorganism. They are made up of microorganism which is killing the disease-causing microorganism. Very important point here. See, let's see the examples here. Streptomycin, tetracycline, erythromycin. This type of antibiotics are commonly used. Okay, it's commonly used in market. Disease-causing microorganism is called pathogen. See here, we have seen this word disease-causing microorganism. It got killed with the medicines which we are taking. And these disease-causing microorganisms are known as pathogens. Okay, remember this word, pathogens. What are pathogens? Disease causing microorganism in human being, in animal, okay, in plants, these are known as pathogens. So let's see, our body produces antibodies which fight against pathogens. Inside our body, in blood, we have WBC. What is that? White blood cells. White blood cells of the blood plays important role. Very important point I am telling you. White blood cell plays important role to fight against the pathogens. What are pathogens? Disease causing microorganisms are known as pathogens. So white blood cell plays important role in fighting this type of microorganism, and antibodies protect us. These antibodies, where are they present? In WBC. These antibodies protect our body from the microorganism, disease causing microorganism. Very important point. So that's why if your body is healthy, this microorganism can fight very easily. So this was all about today. What we have seen here, we discuss about making of curd and bread. We see the commercial use of microorganism Then we see medicinal use of microorganism, these three topics are very much important related to microorganism, and some of the definitions also, like fermentation, pathogens, etc. So this was all about today. Thank you.